All right, as we do as every meeting, we do a COVID community update slide. So we do have some new numbers for you, thanks to the county. Next slide. You've seen these before. These are COVID at a glance numbers, and we do show the nationwide and state of California numbers. And thankfully, our 7-day positivity state level has dipped below the 10% for the first time for our positivity rate numbers. So that's showing trends in the right direction. But new numbers are showing now our reported recovery cases, and this was at a request of community members and the county heard, and so they are now providing those points of data. So I will go over those with you. But first, we have about 58,290 confirmed cases in San Joaquin County, 50,998 total recovered, 319 hospitalized as of today, and 786 fatalities. And for Tracy, the county's reporting 5,762 cases and 48 deaths in Tracy since the start of the pandemic. And we have about, of that 5,762, about 86 has recovered. As you can see, that's noted on the slide. And then it's estimated about 12% of the current cases will end up being hospitalized, for the first weekend of this month. And 31% of those patients hospitalized will need ICU care. Next slide. Effective January 12th, the Greater Sacramento region met the criteria to exit the regional stay-at-home orders, and counties in that region immediately went back to their appropriate tiers based on cases and test positivity rate. Unfortunately, that does not apply to Tracy and San Joaquin County, which is the San Joaquin County Valley region. Our stay-at-home order for the region will remain in place until the California Department of Public Health's 4-week projections of the San Joaquin County Valley region total available ICU bed capacity is greater or equal to 15%. Our current ICU capacity for our region is still at 0%, and our adult ICUs are operating at 138% capacity. We had about 319 COVID positive patients admitted for care as of yesterday, and we have 6 patient deaths due to COVID in the past 24 hours. Next slide. Our current tier status is, as you know, purple widespread, which could apply to our county after the regional stay-at-home order is lifted. San Joaquin County's current adjusted case rate is 76.7 per 100,000, and 17.2% is our current positivity rate. In order for our county to move up from the purple to the red tier, our county daily new cases would need to come down 4 to 7 per 100,000, and our positivity rate needs to be between 5 and 8%. Next slide. We have some good news. Curative walk-up COVID testing is now available on Sundays at Tracy Ritter Family Ballpark. That's 2300 North Tracy Boulevard, Sundays from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. And you can sign up for an appointment online, and it's listed there on the slide. Just to let you know a little bit about the process, it's a painless mouth swab. It's not in your nose, which is great. It's a lot more comfortable, and it's self-collected by the patient. Results are usually available within 48 hours from receipt of the lab and are delivered electronically. We also want folks to know that the pop-up COVID site that's located in Tracy at the Tracy Sports Complex is still operating Monday, Wednesday, and Friday from 9 to 12, and also offers the self-swab test as well. And the Planned Parenthood staff that is there can walk you through the self-swab process, and it's absolutely pain-free, as I noted earlier. Next slide. This is a slide of the current phases for the vaccines. COVID vaccines are now being given in phases according to priority groups. That's as directed by the California Department of Public Health, and it's also noted on this vaccine schedule. These priority categories are based on the state vaccine advisory work groups and the National CDC Advisory Committee on the Immunization Practices. Next slide. So the vaccines are ongoing in San Joaquin County, and residents in the 3 tiers of 1A only are eligible to receive COVID vaccinations as of right now. Currently, our county's vaccine supply is adequate to vaccinate the groups in phase 1A only. When our county department of health progresses into phase 1B or opens to any more priority groups as per the state guidelines and vaccine supply, or if the vaccine supply increases, you can go to sjcph www.cvs.org, and you can get an update on what is available and who is available to get vaccines. Our public health officer provided an update to the County Board of Supervisors earlier today, and that will be shared tomorrow on our social media platforms, also with any subsequent press releases that have been issued or that will be issued by the county. Next slide. This information came from Dr. Galley's update, which was earlier today on the COVID-19 variant, which you may have heard about in the news. The state is still working to determine how broad the variant is across the state and exactly on what it will mean in terms of its infectiousness and implications on the effectiveness of the vaccines. We look forward to receiving more information as it becomes available. Next slide. Just a reminder that we do put all of this information in our COVID electronic newsletter. You can go to the Tracy's website, www.cityoftracy.org, and click on our news section, and you can sign up to receive it. That concludes my report.